able to come and visit us over here at the police station for the city of Reidsville. On the behalf of the city of Reidsville, I'd like to welcome you as we recognize Chief of Police Robert Hassell. This is an important day, not only for our police department, but also for the city and its citizens, as Chief Hassell is sworn in as our new Chief of Police. Chief Hassell brings many fine qualities to the job, and City Manager Michael Pearce will be discussing those as he introduces the Chief in a few minutes.
Lord, we thank you for this occasion. We thank you for this day. We thank you for all that you've allowed us to feel and all that you've allowed us to experience. Now, Lord, it is our prayer that you continue to lead us, guide us, and direct us into the future, both now and into the future. Now, Lord, bless all that we do now and that we do in the days ahead. For these and all the blessings we ask and we pray. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
It's a big day for Reidsville. Big day, and it's my pleasure to introduce the new Chief Police Chief, Robert Hassell, to the city of Reidsville. But before I do that, I think I'd like to thank somebody in particular. I'd like to thank the man who has served us as the interim Chief of Police for these last few months for the excellent work he's done for us as Chief of Police while we were searching for our next chief. And Captain Ellison, thank you so much from the bottom of my heart.
And so there's no doubt in my mind that we have found
the, by far and large, the best candidate that applied for the position of Chief of Reidsville. And I was so happy when I not only saw that Robert was interested in coming to Reidsville, but he was the most qualified candidate that we had. Now let me tell you a little bit about Robert's background. He went to high school in Jamesville, North Carolina, which is in the eastern side of the state. He got his basic law and enforcement training, the BLET training, at Pitt Community College in 1995. He earned his associate's degree in general studies from University of Mount Olive in 2003. He received his bachelor's degree in justice administration from the University of Mount Olive in 2004. He got his master's degree in public administration from Central Michigan University in 2007, and he's currently working on his doctorate, and my understanding he's close to finishing his doctorate degree. Very impressive resume. He started his law enforcement career in Kinston, North Carolina in 1995, rising to the rank of sergeant for the Special Response Unit. In 2005, he moved to Fairmont, North Carolina, where he was the Director of Public Safety, the chief for that position. He was the chief of police in Hope Mills in 2009. He moved to Fayetteville State University in 2012 and became the associate vice chancellor and the chief of police for public safety in 2012 in Fayetteville State. His professional affiliations, they're very numerous. But what I was interested in was that he was a member of the International Association of Chiefs of Police and also on the executive board for the North Carolina Chief of Police Association. You know, what I found out is not only checking with his references and people that knew him, that Robert is very well known, liked, and respected, not only in North Carolina, but there's a lot of people further away that really like and respect Robert. So on paper, Robert was very qualified. But you know, there were other items in his resume that really separated his application from some of the others. The honors and awards that the Chief Hassell's had over the years. Officer of the Year in 1998. Twice he received awards for saving human lives. Twice he's received a Medal of Valor. The Chief's Distinguished Service Award in 2000. Community Service Award in 1996. This is a gentleman that's been recognized for his community work, for his police work, for his dedication and his courage. But beyond that, what really caught my eye were the community awards and recognitions that he's received over the years. I've received on his resume 9 different awards, mostly 7 of those dealing with his role as an advisor to explorer units for the Boy Scouts. That really caught my eye. We're really interested in working with young people in Reidsville. We see this as such an important part of our community life, and obviously will be for our future. Robert has been recognized 7 times as an exploring leader, and that tells me how engaged and how sincere he was in working with young people. But the clincher for my choosing Robert to be the next chief of police was really in our interviews and our talks. We talked several times in person, several times on the phone, and it just showed me the type of person that he really was. I was interested. You look at the resume, you look at the awards he's given, but then you can tell by talking to somebody some of the values that he could bring to city of Reidsville. His desire to be of service to the public. You know, I know that when he worked for the University of Fayetteville State University, I think he was enjoying that job, but he expressed to me over and over his desire to get back to municipal work, to work in cities, to work with people, communities, young people. And I think that really drove him to seek the job in Reidsville. The desire to be a team player, to work with other departments, agencies, and individuals for a common good. I can just see that in the conversations that we had. The desire to be a good steward of public monies. I know the city council would be thrilled to hear that. But sincerely, when we were talking, some of the things he would talk about, I would say, that sounds great. But I was really pleased to hear him talk about public monies. It was something that we really regard. And most importantly, though, is his desire to work with young people. to be a leader and source of inspiration to young people that can turn lives around and turn Reidsville into the community we want it to be. So I am so pleased and proud that Robert Hassell was interested in joining our team with the City of Reidsville as the new Chief of Police. And it's my extreme pleasure and honor to introduce him today and to swear him in. So welcome to Reidsville, Chief. I'm so glad you're here with us.
I want to recognize Chief Hodges here in the front row. Center Chief. He was retired chief from Hope Mills. He's from Eden area. Thank you, Chief. I am on the executive board of the Chiefs Association. Chief Hodges was the chief of police in Hope Mills at the time, and I was chief of police in Fairmont. And he encouraged me to run for a position as a regional director for Region 6 at that time. So thanks to Chief and the fine job he did with Hope Mills PD, where I also served as chief following him. But helped me get into the leadership role of the Association of Chiefs of North Carolina. So I really thank you, Chief, for all the things you've done for me. Thank you, sir. I see Captain Survey in the back from Hope Mills, and my fine Miss Jerry Morton in the back. Thank you guys for what you've done in Hope Mills and helping get where I'm at. So many things, I'm going to leave anybody out. But I do recognize Chief Hunt and Chief Festival. You've done a great job here in the department, and I recognize that. The staff recognizes that. So thank you for the strong foundation you have already built here, or laid here, I should say. And I will do my best to continue to build on that strong foundation to help lead this department to bigger and better things, to serve the public good here in Reidsville. But out of all the things I've done in my career, all the successes, and there have been a few little bumps here and there, but all the successes I've had could not have been done without support from the citizens. It couldn't have been done without support of the city government, and commissioners, or the council people, but more importantly, the staff that I work with. Without the staff that I work with in past agencies, I couldn't have done the things I've done, and I can't do anything without the strong support of the members here of the Reidsville Police Department already. For a couple of days I've been here, I see I have their support. I have very talented, skilled professionals here, and I look forward to working with each and every one of you and meeting all of you over the next few weeks here. The manager hinted on me loving the work of youth. That is a passion of mine. Growing up in a violent home and found a single mom, moved into the housing developments. I remember one day, young boy in housing projects, and an officer by the name of Officer Payne came by with me looking for proofs to come to one of the police explorers. And that is when I got introduced to Boy Scouts of America. And from that day when I put that uniform on, that badge that said explorers, I knew I wanted to be a police officer. Because of Officer Payne, he had put something in my mind and in my heart that I wanted to serve people. And from that day forward, that was always a long-life dream of mine. And I was able to serve that. I actually lived that dream. I'm still living that dream today. And every day I get up to come to work, I'm truly happy. And you have your dark days, but I have more good days, more bright days than anything, because I love helping people. I love helping everyone in the public. But I really still had a strong reach for working with people. And this is the last story. But one day I was in Kinston. I had on a uniform as an officer, and I was assigned to patrol one of the housing communities, and a little child was out the back door. And he looked at me with those big brown eyes and he said, what you doing out here? And I said, well, I'm here to walk around and make sure you and your family are safe. And he immediately, without hesitation, said, don't come to my house. And I said, well, why? And he immediately said, because you're going to arrest my mom. Immediately that young boy thought that if I or any other law enforcement came to his home, I was going to arrest somebody. And that bothered me. That how young children, he was only maybe 7 or 8 years old, how he looked at law enforcement. From that day forward, I did anything I could to interact in a positive way with our youth and communities. One, to be a positive role model like Officer Payne did for me when I was in my teens, but just for that young boy that day in the house of the government, to try to make sure that he see us in a positive way, because I understood that many times when we do our jobs, we are arresting people who have committed some kind of crime. But he don't see it that way, because that person can be a role model for him in maybe not in the best of ways, but it's someone bringing him food and support in the home. It could be a father, it could be a brother, someone that he loves. So I had to be wherever I could, and that's why I have a real strong interest, and I look forward to working with our youth here in these and surrounding areas. So if there's anyone in that program who's like for our fine community policing unit or myself to come speak with, please let me know. But again, I'm thankful of being here in Reidsville. I look forward to many, many years being here, like so many of our staff have been for many years. And look forward to working with each and every one of you. Thank you so much.